In our hobby, proxying with unofficial models is a contentious issue, chiefly in the tournament scene. Don't get us wrong, Citadel miniatures are well sculpted and sport official looking designs that are either directly from or inspired by the Peter Jackson films. While quite a few factions are well served with up-to-date plastic miniatures, many armies are given the short end of the stick, minis that are either too expensive or too scarce to be nearly as viable an option as forces like Gondor or Mordor, replete with plastic kits. Most of the more obscure LOTR factions are saddled with pricey metal models sold in sets of 3-6, whereas the Hobbit equivalent are expensive resin kits that are often more pricey than their points value justifies. If you ask me, when a company makes models that fit the bill for your faction of choice, look great, and or save you a tidy sum, you shouldn't be made to feel like you've broken a taboo. I'm Nick from Windrush Wargamers, and here are some great alternatives to GW when it comes to rare, expensive, or unmade models for your MESBG or Battle Companies games. We scoured the Games Workshop store for models that were more expensive for what they are made of resin, from metal, are no longer produced in workable numbers, etc. Anything that could prove to be a barrier for entry for certain factions. We're talking models that carry a similar aesthetic to the cultures and armies presented in the game, but are cheaper, sold in greater numbers, etc. This video will focus on 5 good factions. The next video we're going to do in the series will focus on evil ones. We will not be featuring STLs, since not everyone has access to a 3D printer. Nor will we be covering models that were specifically designed to be used as proxies in this particular game, such as those produced by Hammerin Miniatures or Unreleased Miniatures. Although both are suitable for this purpose, this video would quickly turn into a non-sponsored ad for them, instead of us shopping around. We will, however, be recommending their conversion parts, if not their full models. The first issue we noticed was that the Lake Town Militia are 40 quid, but 12 character sprue of pricey resin models. This puts them at 3 times the standard price per model of a comparable Horde army, such as Goblin Town. For this faction, you would need a group of peasants with vaguely West Turkic and North Slavic aesthetics. Perry miniatures produce angry armed peasants at £7.50 for 6, under a third of the price for half as many, or £15 versus £40 with the same number of minis. There are also 3 separate sets made by Fireforge Games. City Militia from the Medieval Russian faction, a 12 model box that will set you back £19.40. Folk Rabble from the Forgotten World series, which is £17 for 18 models. And the Steppe Warriors from the Deus Vault line, which are 24 models for £23. They all offer great looking militiamen with the right fur coats, hats, and occasionally the trusty Defense 5 Wicker shield that Lake Town is known for. These shields can also be bought from Unreleased Miniatures as makeshift shields for £2.23. If you felt like doing some kit bashing. These kits offer the same mix of cultural dress and improvised weaponry for a fraction of the price, and since they're all made to the same scale, you can kit bash them all together to give yourself a more diverse looking force. Staying with Lake Town, we have the Guard. We love how these boys look, but they suffer from the same 40 quid for 12 resin models problem as their civilian counterparts. The Warriors of Dale, ironically since they're individually a bit tougher, and more expensive points wise, are 10 quid cheaper. For 8 more miniatures with the same cultural look, at 20 for 30. So you could just take these guys, get rid of their shields, and paint them blue if you want to use G-Dub models. If you want to step away from G-Dub and use third-party models, you're looking for spearmen, bowmen, and swordsmen with gambesons and possibly kettle helmets. Fireforge Games have sprues of medieval archers and gambesons and kettle helms for £23. They also do foot sergeants of the same aesthetic but with spear and sword options for £35 for a cool 48 miniatures. Whilst they lack the fur trim and some other details, all it takes is a bit of green stuff. If you could buy the official Heroes of Lake Town, you could pad out your force with these proxies. The foot sergeants alone are 4 times the minis for a 5 or less. Add that to the price of 3 more official sprues and you just saved yourself a tasty £125. The Master of Lake Town himself would be proud of a saving like that.
Save the gold! You heard him!
At the time of writing, these green-clad mad lads aren't even sold by G-Dub. When they are up for sale, they come in expensive metal kits with a handful of men each. Since Honorians are designed to resemble their southern cousins, that's a nice place to start. A 24-man set of Warriors of Minas Tirith will set you back £26. The swordsmen can be converted to carry spears fairly easily, and the White Tree of Gondor can be carved off their shields, upon which you can paint or model the... whatever that is, of Arnor. If you want to go with this method, Unreleased Miniatures do a sprue of 3 Northern Realms heads, which are patterned after the metal Arnorian heads, with banded helmets, for £1.05. With this, you can outfit the 24 warriors for £8.40. They also do a set of 3 Arnorian / Gondorian spears, named Battle Hardened Spears, for 79p per sprue. If you don't feel like sculpting the... whatever that is, of Arnor for every shield, Hammerin Miniatures produced a set of 6 High Kingdom shields for £2.13, and a set of 6 spears for the same price. As an alternative to the warriors of Minas Tirith, Perry Miniatures do Argencore Foot Knights, £20 for a whopping 36 knights have the correct banded helmets, but only a handful of the sprue will have the correct loadout, since only 18 of the 36 men will have spears and none have shields. This is where Hammerin's spears and shields come in handy. Since the Perry twins sculpted much of the Lord of the Rings line, and that's what the Hammerin bits are scaled to fit, the scale is ideal. If you kitted out all 36 of these warriors with the Hammerin spears and shields, you'll still be saving a lot of money. Totaling at £39.17 for 36 warriors, roughly speaking, this is a pound a model, and a third of the price of the official Arnorians when, or if, they ever come back into production. Kitbashing not your thing? Northmen Warriors from Fireforge Games are £16.85 for a full warband of 12 warriors. They're designed to look like the Stark men from Game of Thrones, so they're a lot more distinct from the official Gondorians than the official Arnorians do, while still fitting into the more grounded fantasy aesthetic of the hobby. The heroes are a mixed bag. Any scepter-wielding human male wizard, seer, sage, etc. of the appropriate size with a grounded low fantasy aesthetic will work for Melba, but if you want to collect Arnor, you need Arthur Dewey as a sort of keystone to the army, especially against spirits. Standalone 28mm King miniatures that bear a resemblance to the official model and aren't 3D printable STLs or pricey Etsy product are hard to find. I would try kitbashing Denethor and Theoden together. Alternatively, you can buy the Gondor Commander set from Games Workshop for £24, giving you a bannerman and a captain to convert, along with the Knight of the White Tower, who's just a one-handed sword conversion and some green stuff away from being the perfect Arthur Dewey, in a flowing surcoat and a nice wreathed helm. According to the army rulebook, Arnor can take hobbit archers, which is a nod to the hobbits that were levied by Arthur Dane to fight Angmar. If you'd like to commemorate them, Wargames Atlantic do a more armoured series of halflings that look like they could be hobbits outfitted by a human kingdom, as long as you play them with their official armourless stat block. These guys are a tasty 40 models for £25.50. Although, only 16 of them will be archers. More on this brew in a moment.
Concerning hobbits.
These little blighters are £8.20 for 4 of any kind of hobbit infantry. Bear in mind they're a horde army, so you'll need to pad your forces with dozens of them. We have a sizable hobbit army ourselves, featuring many of the alternate sculpts of the Fellowship Hobbits, and Old Bilbo, to fill out the ranks of the standard hobbit militia. You can get a 12-man hobbit battle company set, of 4 militia, 4 sheriffs, and 4 archers, for £24.60, which isn't a lowered price for them being put together, it's just £8.20 three times. If you wanted more bang for your brandy buck, Oathmark does a 10-man squad of halfling border scouts, who are slingers, for £12. For the same price, you can also have 10 spearmen. They're called spearmen, although they're carrying a mixture of sledgehammers, woodcut axes, farmer bills, and pitchforks. You know, the sort of gear that you'd see the standard militia using as two-handed weapons. This covers the hobbit militia, with two-handed weapons and one-handed weapons, since the slingers are ideal for flavouring their stone-throwing ability. That's 8 more models of militiamen for 50p less. An additional £12 will net you a 10-man squad of archers, or a mixed 10-man squad of soldiers, who come with either dagger/shortsword or a staff, which can be used to proxy sheriffs. Note that Oathmark pack random selections of figures of any given kind, so that even though you'll definitely be getting halfling soldiers, you might not get as good a militia to sheriff ratio as you might want, so just be aware. In the Arnor entry, I mentioned a sprue of halfling militia from Wargames Atlantic. They gave you 40 miniatures for £25.50. These halflings look more like a levied fighting force than the standard hobbits, so they could be a good way to differentiate the regular hobbits from the special upgraded versions that certain heroes allow you to take. The hobbits with the one-handed weapons could be used as the battle and brandy bucks, and the archers could be Tookish hunters. If you have sheriffs, take the halberd ears and chop the shafts down to billy club length. In summary, the Oathmark halflings are roughly a pound a model versus the £2.05 for an official hobbit. Wargames Atlantic Halflings are a tidy 160 in miniature, both considerably cheaper than the GW equivalent. Plus, you get some free halberds out of it. These guys are fairly easy. The Knights of Del Amroth are fairly priced, and the Blackroot Vale archers are literally Ithilien Rangers in blue-grey cloaks. However, the pricing for the rest of their infantry leaves much to be desired. Antediluvian miniatures produce War of the Bruce's Foot Knights, / English Spearmen, / Scots Spearmen, who are pikemen, ideal for the Dol Amroth men-at-arms. Although they don't resemble Weta Workshop's Gondorians as much, there is a lot of model variety, especially if you combine the sets. Each set is £7.50 for 4, against the £16 for 4 official Dol Amroth men-at-arms. Perry miniatures do a set of Irish Galaglass, who are a mix of two-handed axemen and two-handed swordsmen, for £7.50. These guys are well-suited to proxy Axemen of Lossanach and Clansmen of Lamadon, and are the same number of minis for £12.50 less. The Fiefdoms are such an aesthetically diverse faction that if you put these proxies alongside the official models, they'd fit right in. If you thought those guys were expensive, our last pick are by far the most expensive good-aligned faction. It would be very hard to find alternatives in bulk for these miniatures without buying STLs to print yourself. Since most depictions of Dwarven Crossbowmen, or goat/ram cavalry in miniature form, are decidedly more Warcraft than Weta. Unreleased miniatures sell a single Iron Hill shield for 82 pence. In conjunction with these shields, there is a marginally less expensive option of purchasing sets of Warriors of Erebor and sets of Grimhammers from the Army of Thror faction and kitbashing them together. This will give you access to spears, warhammers, and heavily armoured bodies and heads, but will set you back a costly £60 for 48 models, only 38 of which will sport the heavily armoured torso and head/arm/legs for them to be proxied properly. That's not to mention the additional £31.16 that the shields are going to cost you if you buy them individually. For a more effective alternative, Oathmark's Heavy Dwarven Infantry are a good starting point. £25 for 30 dwarves that can be given a mattock-like two-handed weapon or a shield. If you have spears on hand, such as this £4.50 pack of 20 100mm long metal wire spears from Arcane Scenery and Models, you can replace those hand axes with the metal pikes your dwarves deserve. That's £3.75 per dwarf for the cheapest set of Forge World Dwarf Spearmen, versus the Oathmark equivalent, which is £1.20 per dwarf. Alternatively, Conqueror miniatures do a series of heavily armoured dwarves with a late Norse/Anglo-Saxon aesthetic. They don't quite fit the bill for Weta's angular, hard-edged Greco-Roman designs, but they look great, come in spearmen, crossbowmen, or mattock-looking warhammer flavours, at £24 for 16 each, or, in the case of the spearmen, £48 for 32 models. For those keeping score, that's £1.50 for each dwarf against Forge World's £3.75 for spearmen, and £6.66 for the other option. If you want goat riders, ballistae, or other such special models, I would look to unreleased miniatures, whose full models, as I stated at the start, will not be covered here. A quick note about scale. These being minis made for various different games by various different companies, the scaling of these models is not entirely consistent. GW's models are not immune to this themselves, however. I feel the need to state for the record that this video is not intended to disparage anyone who has purchased the official Citadel miniatures at full price. To do so would be to criticise ourselves, since almost all of our miniatures are Games Workshop official, save for a few conversion bits here or there. The goal of this video was to help tear down a few barriers for entry to collecting some of the less supported factions in the game. We would definitely recommend buying the proper Citadel minis for your faction of choice, especially the heroes. During the making of this video, we've been discussing collecting some of these armies, specifically the survivors of Lake Town, the Lake Town Guard, and Arnor. Maybe we'll make future videos detailing just how we put these lists together. I know these proxy options will definitely help. Well, that's all, guys. Thank you very much for sticking with us to the end. I know this was a very long one. Know of any more good options we missed? Or options for good aligned armies we didn't cover? Or do you feel inspired to make an army or battle company of your own with the proxies we listed? Let us know in the comments down below. Stay tuned, because in a future video, we'll be listing possible proxies for some of the evil factions in the game. Check out our other videos, subscribe if you want to, and stay safe.